Taneční kreace mistra Groka.
Il mio nome è Matej Minac, sono un regista e ho fatto un film intitolato All My Loved Ones, basato sui ricordi di mia madre, della sua infanzia. Mia madre è cresciuta in una grande e felice famiglia ebrea. Si divertivano e si godevano la vita. Gli zii, i cugini, molti in famiglia si godevano la vita. Non potevano immaginare che qualcosa sarebbe potuto accadere alla famiglia, perché la Cecoslovacchia era molto liberale. Il nazismo cresceva e loro avevano la possibilità di andarsene, ma non lo fecero. Pensavano, cosa ci potrebbe accadere? Poi, basandomi su quello che ho imparato dalla storia, ho introdotto la figura di Nicholas Vinton, che arrivò a Praga nel 1939. Lui vide il pericolo più chiaramente degli altri e capì immediatamente che qualcosa doveva essere fatto. Organizzò 7 treni per i bambini da Praga fino a Londra. E fece in modo che andassero tutti a vivere in famiglie britanniche. Così riuscì a salvarne 700. Erano principalmente, anche se non tutti, bambini ebrei. Molti ora sono famosi, come Karl Reiss, il regista del film con Meryl Streep, L'amante del tenente francese.
I wanted to go to a school where I would have to do nothing, so I think that going to cinema is not such a difficult job, so I decided I will study directing, but it turned out that it's terribly difficult. Maybe it's more difficult than this mathematics. Only when I went to the university, I really started to look very intensively at pictures, and I was very moved by a few pictures like Crusader Potemkin, because for example, in these movies are the most fundamental things which are used in good movies even nowadays. This film, you know, is a little bit All My Loved Ones is like a neorealist film in that way that they said that if you have a little newspaper article about something, you can make the whole film out of it, you know, about something. So we actually start the film with a newsreel about this Nicholas Vinton, that he came to Prague and that he rescued 700 children and so. So it's like a little piece of news. And then we start in the film tell what really happened and how did he get to Prague and everything. So it's somewhere near to this. After the Velvet Revolution, in Czechoslovakia, everything what was before a taboo, people wanted to learn. And so there were plenty of real stories which people were very interested in, and it was great fun to do these things because, for example, about Tomáš Baťa and his family, a documentary film, half of the nation was watching it. You know, for a documentary, it's incredible. So but it is not possible anymore. It was such a period.